Mike Wilmer.
James Abrams, Coach James Poole Abrams, Hoopology Basketball. Sterling's camp has been a success for the last 2 years. It has fallen up under our umbrella of Hoopology Basketball. He was one of my former campers at Hoopology Basketball Camp, and we worked with him along with a couple of other friends of his to establish other programs just like Hoopology. So Beyond the Court has fallen up under Hoopology's umbrella. He has his own lane now. This, again, is his second year, and I think we've been blessed. I think he's almost doubled his numbers. I think he has over 150-something kids here, which is a great testimony for him, serving the city of Camden. We've been working together probably for the last 5 or 6 years on doing other camps for everybody else, so we decided about 3 years ago to establish this program. I think it's an up-and-coming program here in the Southeast. We have a lot of professional players that have played overseas, and a lot of collegiate players to come through and speak to the kids. So it's been a great opportunity for the kids and also for our staff.
How y'all doing? I'm Sterling Council. It's my second annual basketball Beyond the Court camp. It's a great turnout. I appreciate everybody, the community, the support, and everybody. Gave it the turnout it is. I hope the kids have fun. I hope they learn something. Just 3 days, you're not going to be the player you want to be. So hopefully you got something from the camp. You take it with you. And it's beneficial for you. Once again, I thank you. And for attending the second annual Beyond the Court Basketball Camp. I'm Sterling Council. Thanks.
South Carolina, Armo, South Carolina, with the Dutch War High School. Here with my boy Sterling at Beyond the Court Basketball Camp. Man, I really enjoyed just being here with the kids, man, working with them. We got a great group of guys, about 150 kids. I just enjoyed being here, being able to support my friends. Glad to see you giving back to the community and doing a great job.
My name is this camp was the greatest experience. You know, it teaches you a lot, you know. You learn a lot on your game. You can perfect your craft for this camp. You know, overall, they teach you the basics and all. Stuff like that.
About the best.
scoop up. First scoop up. White line, half court, white line. Then you're done. Shot, shot, shot. Right.
Oh, hey.
Come back. Left.
Hey.
Right.
Hey.
Left.
Hey.
Let's go. Let's go.
What I learned at this time was to be a versatile all-around player.
My name is Adrian. What I learned at this time was to be a versatile all-around player. My name is Tyreek, and I learned at this time to never give up, even though you do.
Hey, my name is Sean Seville, and I'm going to be a tail ball handler.
My name is Elijah, and I'm learning how to play football.
Hey, my name is Jason. I'm learning how to pass the ball, dribble, and do the one I like to.
Point here, a shuffle here, get back. Point here, a shuffle here, get back. Point here, boom. You go four cones, keep your feet hot, you're gonna blow the whistle. You get it.
My name is Bill. I learned how to move my left hand and do it later.
My name is Isaiah, and this week, I'm like, this, yeah, these 3 days I learned that, that you should just like listen to coaches and you learn new things. And it's fun. It's not boring. And once you, the first day might be hard, but the other two, it's really.
My name is Riley Murphy, and I learned how to be a leader.
My name is Jason Carrier. I learned not to dribble on the corner because that's where I get trapped and I get the ball thrown.
Coaching, thank you for coming back and doing this stuff. Let's give one more big round of applause.
Coach said, my name is Bonnie Holliday, and I grew up right here in Camden, South Carolina, actually just on the other side of this field in this cemetery, downtown Camden, Lord Street. So I've been running around this neighborhood for a very long, long time. So I know what it's like to be your age and living in Camden. I know some things have changed around me, right? A lot of things have changed since I left. Like you said, I graduated in 1994 at Camden High School. I was one of the first teams to play in this gym. Come on with that whole dog pound sign over there. I was one of the first teams to play. You know, when I played, you put that up. I played basketball. My first sport was baseball. I went on to play football. It became my love. Right? So I got a scholarship in 1994 at the University of North Carolina, where I went to go play football. And I could have gone to South Carolina, Florida State, Ohio State. All I got recruited by all the college. And that would not have happened if I didn't have the grades, right? I had to have the grades to get to college. All this stuff coming back to Canada and having an opportunity to talk to you, I would have never had that opportunity had I not made the grades to go to college, graduate college, and make it onto the NFL. I got drafted in 1998 after leaving the University of North Carolina and went on to play for the Green Bay Packers. I was a first-round draft. Couldn't believe it, man. Sports that I watched on TV every Sunday. Right, just like you guys watch on Sunday and Monday night, right? Sunday night. I'm going to the league, playing with guys like Brett Favre, Reggie White. Some of you guys don't know those guys, they're older. But playing with people that I had a poster of, people that I watched on TV. Now I'm one of those guys. I didn't know that when I was sitting here in camp, in church, and in school, and in classes, right here in Camden, South Carolina, that one day I would make it to the NFL. One day I would have a chance to go off. Playing a profession that pays you millions of dollars to play, right? Never thought I'd do that. Never thought I'd have a chance to come back in the game that I love, that I played as a kid, since I was your age, right? I've been playing football since I was your age, out back in the backyard with my buddies. We're out here in the fields and down at Zim Stadium, right? Out at the recreation department playing football. Never thought that game would bring me the lifestyle, the things that I was able to do, right? Able to change my situation, able to buy my mother a house, right? Able to buy my mother a car. Able to buy knock my old house down that I lived in right down here in Camden, South Carolina, and build it up to make it a new one, right? Cool thing to do, right? Great thing to do, right? Cool. Nothing like it, man. Nothing like being able to come back to my community and give money and time to all of the different causes. To be able to come back here today and have a conversation and talk with you guys. One thing I saw, and it's always interesting, when I come back and I watch kids and I talk to kids, I always look to see, and it never fails, all the cool kids want to go where? To the back. If we had come in here today, and Sterling said, I'm giving away the new Jordans that are going to be released this weekend, how many of you guys would be able to go to the back of the line for those? You would go to the back of the line for Jordans? You gotta be the first one there. You're gonna come up, sit up front, right? You're gonna get up front for the new James, right? Well, if I say I'm giving away $50 or $100, you guys are gonna be the first people in line, right? You're gonna be in the front row. Guys, listen up. That's what you're getting an opportunity almost every day. In the classroom, I don't know if you guys don't like it, in church, at this camp, right? Don't go to the back. Don't be those guys. Come to the front of the room. Take advantage of the opportunity. Get it all. Even if you don't like it, just do it. Just do it. People like to see it. People like to see it. Teachers, coaches. If I'm a coach and I come to recruit you or I come to your school, nowadays they want to see what kind of person you are, right? They want to see, can I trust you? They want to see you. Impress me. Do something different. Get out of the bathroom. And I might say it's a bad thing, but I remember I was a kid. I wanted to be cool too. Sometimes I was in the bathroom. Of all the knowledge. The one thing that was said about me when I got to the University of North Carolina and they went on to the NFL was that I was a sponge, right? Everyone that ever met me, they was like, this guy's a sponge because I wanted to soak up as much knowledge, as much information as I could because I wanted to be the best me that I could be, right? I didn't know that I was going to be an NFL player. I didn't know. But I got to Carolina, I wanted to play as a true freshman, right? Which is hard to do. I was the most highly recruited guy coming out of high school. Yeah. I was recruited high, but when I was in Carolina, there was all these big-time 4-5A star athletes getting brought in there, much bigger, much stronger, come from bigger programs. But one thing that they weren't going to do was outwork us, right? And I don't know what you guys want to do. You ladies, I don't know what you want to do. I don't know what you want to do with your life. I don't know if you want to be a basketball player. I don't know if you want to be a basketball coach. I don't know if you want to be a football player. I don't know. Baseball. I don't know what it is you want to do. Attorney, doctor, lawyer. I don't know what it is you want to do. Attorney general, governor of South Carolina, mayor of Camden, be in the army. Whatever it is you want to do, I promise you, one thing I can promise you is that it's going to take work, right? It's going to take hard work. And if you are afraid to work, you got a long life ahead of you. A long life ahead of you. And you can do anything that you want to do in life if you work at it. And if you're not afraid to work at it. Right? Hard work doesn't care who does it, guys. It doesn't care. I don't know how many of you guys want to play basketball. Maybe you just want to play in college. I don't know if you want to go to the NBA. You want to go to the NBA? Cool. You think Steph, have you guys seen that special lately on Steph Curry? How he worked with his shot, even after getting, you know, in high school. He's hurt because he's balling right now. He's got to give the brother a business again tonight, bro. Huh? Yeah, you're right. Oh, get back. Okay, I'm sorry. Dollar back here. Hey. It's up. So what I'm saying is, it takes hard work. Steph Curry didn't just get that shot overnight. Steph Curry shot. How many times do you think he shot? 100. Thousands of times. Same shot. Every spot on the court, right? Thousands of times. Every spot on the court, he shot the ball, right? He didn't just roll out of bed and become Steph Curry. He's been putting the work in. LeBron James didn't just roll out of bed and become LeBron James. He's been working for a long time. And so, the same type of work that you put in on this court, though, what else do you have to put it in?
School.
In school. You have to do it in school. You have to do it in school because if you're not making the grades, you can't play ball, right? You can't play. So as much as you love, as much passion you have for whatever sport it is, or whatever drives you, have that same type of passion for school, because you can't get there otherwise, right? And I know, I have two kids. I have a 10-year-old son and a 16-year-old daughter. And in my house, all we ask of our kids is to give a great effort at whatever it is. And that's the same thing as in school. Everybody's not an all-A student, right? It's just not how it is. But you got to give your best effort and then get help along the way, right? Ask for help. Talk to your teacher. Everybody around you wants to see, they want to see you succeed. I promise you, there's no teacher out there that if you have a good attitude and you work hard, is not going to go out of their way to help you get to where you want to go to. But if you come into that classroom, or you come into my gym, or you come into my football field with a bad attitude, I'm not even inclined to help you out. It's just not. You're a problem. You're a problem. There are people out here who want to get to you, but you got to have a great attitude. You gotta have great gifts. Don't mind giving great effort to get whatever it is you want. Hold on 1 second. Look at your question in a second. That's a good question. To get where you want to get to. The most important thing to me, or one of the most important things to me in life, is a positive attitude. A positive attitude. Why do you think that's important? One of the older guys. Give me a positive. Listen up. No, it's important to help you get where you want to get to, right? So things might not be great right now, right? And in life, things happen, right? All the time. Things happen. You study hard, maybe in class, or in a game. You go out in a game, you play as hard as you can, you ball it, but you might not win the game, right? It's just how it is. The other team had a better day. Do you give up and not come back and play next game? No, you keep working, right? You gotta work hard. You keep working. Simple. Little man right here was talking about a bowling game that he's playing, and he didn't get the high score, but he didn't give up. He kept playing until he got the high score. That's how life is, guys. You can't give up. And I know that sounds simple, and some of the other kids laugh about it, but that's how life is, right? In life, if I give you a video game, I bring you the brand new, I don't know what game it is. Okay. Black Ops 2. I play Black. I play all of it. I play 2K. I play all. I play Madden. I play all of it. No, you guys should not be playing GTA. None of you guys should be playing GTA. You be up here. Nobody down here should be playing GTA. Real quick, real talk, y'all. You guys should be playing GTA. Don't say anything. GTA is not for your age. I know it's not. My son tried to play. He's 10. I'm not letting him play it. So I have to sneak and play it myself.
Yeah, damn.
Right? I'm old. But I do play. But I'm saying, you know the work that you put in on those video games? Try to get to the next level and try to get through those? That's the kind of work, those missions, that's the kind of work you got to put in your life. That's the kind of work you got to put in your life. That's the kind of work you got to put in at your sport, whatever it is. It's no different, right? It's amazing how you can put that work in on those games, but when it comes to life, school, whatever the ball, if you're playing ball, you don't want to put the same work in. So I encourage you, don't be afraid of hard work. Even you little people, don't be afraid of hard work. Outwork the person next to you. Right? You
want to
be the best, right?
You want to
be the best.
My name is Dan Benjamin. I'm a counselor, coach here, beyond the court, second year. Appreciate my boy Stella for doing this camp. A lot of kids came this year. They have fun, working hard, shooting, passing, dribbling, scrimmaging, teamwork, building in young lives, man. It's a great thing you're doing out here in Camden. It's only going to get bigger and bigger. We appreciate your support. Keep supporting. Thank you.
Daniel Castle, and I learned new agility drills.
Josh Castle, Stella Castle, this week has been a success. We had a lot of kids, good turnout, a lot of support. My brother showed around, did everything he did. We had a lot of feedback from our friends, family, everybody helped out. Good success. Kids learning, dribbling, boxing out, playing defense, offense, good sportsmanship, being a good team player. Thank you, that's it.
Play ball, win game. Stella Council beyond the court camp. Had a great week with the kids. Great turnout. We continue. Great progress.
I'm going to go
George Young, the white man first. On my whistle. Ready? We have a count. One. Two.
Everybody is hitting now, and I learned how to use the spin move to paint.
My name is Fonzo Wilson, and I learned how to play basketball.
My name is Taylor Caldwell. I learned how to do a left hand layup and dribble.
My name is Rich Nelson. We're at Beyond the Court Basketball Camp, second annual. Shout out to Sterling Cancer, man. We're doing a lot of positive things for the community, giving the kids something to do. So we had a great turnout. Plan to get bigger and bigger every year. Y'all stay tuned for next year. Grand event.
I'm Marquita Warren. I'm Sterling Council's sister. This is the second year of Beyond the Court. He's now incorporated, and we're very proud of him giving back to his community and doing things for the kids around here. It's been an awesome experience, and look forward to next year. Thank you all for attending.
My name is Travis Thompson, and I came to Beyond the Court Camp to improve my basketball skills. I learned a lot of things. I learned how to improve my shooting, ball handling, and defense.
I learned more basketball skills and how to take care of myself and how to be a man. How y'all doing? I'm Coach Josh Dollar. We're Beyond the Court. This is our third year doing the camp, man. And, you know, for a third year, we had success. Got 157 kids this year, man. And it's been a pleasure working with these kids, working with the other coaching staff, the owner of the camp, Sterling Council. Good job this year, man. Look forward to next year.
My name is Boris Cooper. What I learned at camp is how to create all the people. Let's see, Bobbles, let's go.
My name is Ari Bradford, and for what I learned at camp is learn how to dunk for people. You already know how I get there.
My name is Scott, and I learned how to shoot, dunk, and I know how to dribble.
My name is Kyle Trayon Perry.
Hi,
I'm Trayon Perry. The camp is pretty good. The kids were good. They learned a lot.
My name is Nara Stephan, and I learned drills, and we had to do a lot of pushing.
How do you use my
name is Jatiana Lee, and I learned at camp that if you want to play sports or whatever, you need education.
My name is Phil, and I learned how to be a team player.
My name is Mila Jackson, and I learned if you want to do something, you have to keep going for it. You can't stop.
My name is Israel Macklin, and I have learned how to dribble better and shooting more.
Thank you.
everybody, man. This is Coach X, man. I had a real good time this year, second year doing it. I had age group 10 through 13, had a good time. Had a lot of fundamentals that they taught me this year. And you know what I'm saying? We're going to keep it up beyond the court.